very basics of F-Start is this.
So you just want to stand wide-legged.
Balance for the person that is in your open guard. I shouldn't stop here, and he's not going to want to stop here
because he's going to want to move, and I kind of
have to keep constantly moving him, moving him, moving him. Because I have these hooks. The thing with X is that it's not X like this. I mean, sometimes it is the lift, but the X consists of me hooking his left knee and creating pressure that way, while this foot creates pressure that way, so I can lift. I lift because my left knee shin is on his thigh, so I'm holding his weight basically with my left leg. But if I load his weight above my hips, he becomes very light. If you're here and they break the grip, that's common. You can grab a belt and you can lift. You can have a lot of torque with this belt, because this belt also keeps him from getting away from me. So does this right here. Because the thing with X guard is that if he's able to get off this hook, like with his hand and back steps, they will typically pass here. Okay? And that's a common thing. So you're here, here, and you should be able to load their weight. Also, you can grab the pant leg here. And there's a variety of sweeps depending on which way you shift their weight. Okay? Because from here, begin to do them back that way. Now we're lock control into that way so he can't get up. Alright. Now the question is, how do we get in here from the daily Eva? We got in here like this. Okay. So here's the daily Eva. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna load his weight, looking to the right, and it's on the knee, here, here, and my left hand. He seems his foot, okay? Because as you see here, I already have an ankle lock, okay? And I think if you, I'll do it from different angle, okay? But you see how he's, his weight is completely shifted right there, okay? So now you see what my feet are doing. If he wants to bring his weight back, he's gonna want to get this foot, put this foot back on the mat to create stability here, okay? So I'm gonna work out this a little bit. What I want to do is I want to shift his weight to the right, okay, and kind of push him away. Because from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my right leg to his hip, lift my hips here, and then finish a super tight ankle lock that barely crushes my forearm. And I'll show you guys just so that you can just get into it without having to go from daily Eva. For those of you who are a little bit more on the seasoned side, okay, you have with this hand holding to the right, reach this leg in, slide underneath, one, two, and then I'm going to keep tilting as you see right here, okay? My left hand, I'm just exaggerating. I wouldn't let go because I don't need to right now, okay? And my left hand grabs my collar. Okay, so a couple things basically happen here. He's not going to want to give this up because he's feeling ankle lock, and typically they'll push their foot back to the mat. If he pushes back to the mat right here, okay, oftentimes he feels safe here. But if he starts posturing up, this controls the grip. If he breaks my grip, which is common right here, you can grab this and then climb. One. The reaction oftentimes is I stand up really strong. But here, it's a really tight ankle. Now, you have to get your hips up here. You can even triangle your legs here, pull here, okay? And then finish that ankle up. if he falls and sits, I'm gonna let go just because it will he'd fall right in there. Really super tight ankle lock. Okay. And here, really, really super tight. There's different ways too. It's a different concept. Is and I tilt him this way here, and I'll explain to you why I'll do it from another angle here, okay? Because from here, I can pull him this way here. This foot also enables me to elevate my hips, and so does this. Look, one, two. This is already super, super tight. If he stands up, he puts himself even in a tighter ankle lock. If he slowly sits back, it's really super tight and very legal. Watch what happens to his, what's his foot called? Top of the foot? Instep. This right here. Okay. Anyway, I'm not a psychiatrist. Look, I like to get this pan grip here, the Andrew Lowe grip. Pull him in and push him away. Tilt to the right. One, two, three. As I tilt him, notice how this happens right here.
For sure.
And you go from the pants to the ankle. The foot right here. Okay, so now his instep or top of the foot or whatever is on my left lap. So here, you lift the hip. You see how my hips are literally by his hip. So whatever he's gonna do, so if I'm here, it's tight. If he sits, just watch your feet. Right here, okay? Even here, it's tight. Even if he grabs my collar to try to push his foot through here, I can still begin to finish it. And it's super, super, super tight, okay? How to get in it? You're gonna just, if you wanna just get into the X guard here, okay? You're gonna go one, two, and three. Just so that from here, you can feel how easy it is to load the weight. He puts his foot on the mat, that way, he leans back the other way, and you constantly keep moving and shifting, moving, shifting. So you're constantly testing the balance here, okay? So now as he postures up, he sits, I let go just a little bit, and then even from here. Because that's legal, it's not real. And then if you put your thumb up, it's even worse versus flat. Yeah. You can get into X guard. You don't even have this hand here. You should be able to load the weight, lift. Here, constantly moving him around. Lift. I'm lifting him with actually my knee and this foot. Okay. If I'm too far stretched out, notice where my knee is. I always tell you guys, knee has to be inside your belt line, hip line. If he steps out that way a bit, I can't lift effectively. So I gotta in and then lift. And it's not as much easier, okay? So a little bit down with that. So as we're here, look, pull him in. Get that foot off the mat. And that's what I want so I can reach my collar right here. Okay, he puts that foot back on the mat. See how much leverage I have to just balance in here? Even when he's facing away, I won't let him go. Here. And that's even worse, because this is basically the same variation, but you see how it torques the foot.
Is that the ankle or the knee that you're tapping?
Oh, it's the ankle.
It's like the ankle and very bottom of my calf.
Yes, because you hit that soft spot of the calf right here. right on that like Achilles, and it, you can't like flex it here, it won't work as well. Here, maybe, it's right about here. So for you guys that want to just get into X guard, okay? And then as you tilt them, your left hand just to the collar right here. Even you can. Then you can sit him down right in an ankle lock. Super, super tight. And much more effective than getting an ankle lock off low. Okay.
Let's go.
He pushes that foot through. Off of a single leg ass. Which is even that way. And then I'd sit him down for the conventional. Okay. X guard. 2 feet. He punches up, and he pushes this off the hip, and then you go into single leg.
Good
job, Tom. Single leg. So, one last time. Knee back in.
It depends on
how
it is. You skating, so you should stop.
The advanced way of doing it.
But yes, if you're
always
going to extend, and they're scared for you,
you're going to heave them. Vertically.
Attack.
We're going to stand.
Hold.
Here. Here and then still, and right here, you already have it. Okay?
Let's go.
Now from here,
attack,
you can just go.
Attack, attack, attack. Attack the back, attack the back.
Right there.
Let's go.
And his foot is stuck
under
my leg. Super, super tight.
Let's go.
And if you roll your wrist. Good. If he sits, swing to the side. Here, and you can also do it on the opposite side, right? So that's the advanced way to get into it. Just take it easy with the foot locks and don't make big movements. Those of you who want something a little bit more simple, get underneath. Left foot at the hip, right foot, and you gotta constantly be spinning underneath. So your hips have to be able to move. Because if he's trying to get away right here, okay, so we try to get away, I have to be able to adjust. If I just stay here, it's not good enough here, and up here, load his weight up here. Constantly control them and be able to move my hips out in here. I'm too far that way. And my hips out that way. And constant hip movement. Because even from here, look. Here, here, here. And you have that kind of more belly on. It's